Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to Dr. Shazatul Azrin, Major Azalan, and my fellow friends. Today, myself and my friends will be presenting about Proton Holdings Berhad. First, I will present about the introduction about Proton Holdings Berhad. For introduction, firstly, Proton Holdings Berhad, PHB, informally Proton, is a Malaysian automotive firm and automobile agency involved in wheels design, production, giving out and transaction. The firm is headquartered in Shah Alam, Selangor and be in charge of supplementary provision at Proton City Perak, which is situated in Tanjung Malim. Proton was at first a producer of rebased Mitsubishi Motors, MMC, output in 1980s and 1990s. Proton was originally owned in majority by HiCom, with minority stakes being held by Mitsubishi Group members. Proton has been the holder of Lotus Cars since 1996. In May 2017, DRB HiCom state suggestion to bartering a 49.9% prop up in Proton and a 51% prop up in Lotus to Geely Automobile Holdings. On 29 September 2017, DRB HiCom report swap to the board of Proton Holding Berhad. After the agreement of definitive agreement with China Zhejiang Geely Holding Group Limited on 23 June 2017, the Chinese manufacturer of automobiles acquired 49.90% equity in Proton. Proton, by a large department on its domestic market, is nowadays undertake a remodeling procedures as part of a long-term turnabout scheme with anticipate of come back to gainfulness and restoration and external presence.
Hi, I'm Zhao Hao. So now I will present for stage 1, which is input stage to support the Proton Holdings Berhad. This stage consists of 3 things. There are EFE, IFE, and CPM. So first, I will discuss on environmental factors evaluation, EFE metrics. To conduct this EFE metrics, we list the key external factors to categorize as opportunities and then triage. We assign each factor a weight that ranges from 0 to 1 and assign rating between 1 and 4. We multiply each factor's weight by its rating to determine rated score. We will not explain all the factors here since there are too much to present, but we choose the highest and lowest rated score to discuss the analysis. For opportunities, a government imposed import tariff up to 30% thus making it very expensive to buy the imports. Score 0.4 as the highest rated score, while fully utilized Tanjung Malim applying for production score only 0.02, amongst other factors. Next, for ETRETS, well-established car makers had launched hybrid car and sophisticated car that use fuel economically, thus reducing demand for ordinary types of car, score the highest at 0.4, while widening of income disparity between rich and poor has made the rich prefer imported vehicles, score the lowest with only 0.02 amongst other traits. Finally, we sum the weighted score for each variable to determine the total weighted score for the Proton, which is 2.64.
Hi, I am Toh Xiu-Yun. Now I will present about internal factors evaluation metric for Proton Holding Berhad. We assume a weight ranking 0 to 1 to each factors. It is indicated the importance of the factors. We also assume 1 to 4 rating to each factors. Firstly, I will talk about the strength. The rating of 4 is indicated a major strength. The rating of 3 indicated a medium strength. According on the table, the higher wish score is Program Insurance Proton PIP, which is an after-sales service offered more to Proton's customers. The wish is 0.08. Rating is 4 and the wish score is 0.32. The lowest grade is the wish score produced with Mitsubishi we received to the in baddest quality. The company has active major production facility in Tanjung Malim, and Proton has brought 1,635 car worth 555.1 million ringgit Malaysia from June 2018 to August 2019. Their weeks ringding and the wish score are the same. The wish is 0.02, ringding is 3, the wish score is 0.06. Next is talk about the winners. The ringding of 2 means that a major winners. Real terminal winners is ring 1. Employee is lack technical skill, an overall river on government national automotive policy and Bumi Putra suppliers are the higher weak score based on the table. Their weak is 0.08, the ringding is 2, and the weak score is 0.16. The lower weak score is hard for the Proton to estimate the stigma of its power window. The weak score is 0.02 because its wish is 0.02 and the ring is 1. Finally, the total of the wish is 1 and the total of wish score is 2.46. It is indicated a win internally. That's all for me, thank you.
Hi, I'm Zaha. So the following is a competitive profile matrix, CPM, which is the last analysis in this stage. It is used to identify the Proton major's competitors and also their strengths and weaknesses in relation to a sample Proton's strategic position. CPM includes both internal and external factors. In Proton, customer service ranks as the highest weighted score, which is 0.4, while Proton's financial position score as the lowest with only 0.1. Besides, Proton competitors Perodua get the highest weighted score with 0.4 in customer service and the lowest weighted score 0.04 in organization structure. Finally, Nissan as the foreign competitor score 0.4 as the highest rated score in global expansions and customer service, however, only 0.1 in price competitive.
Hi, my name is Joanne. So now I'll continue on the squad matrix of Proton. For the first is strength. So Proton have received around 1.1 billion from Malaysia government for the R&D purpose. For the second, Tanjung Malim plant also expand the manufacturing volume and also provide a new job opportunity. So for the weaknesses, Proton have a low brand image and also brand position, the inferior branding in Malaysia, and also poor after sales service. For the opportunity, they have the new market opportunity in Egypt and they export the Proton Saga and Azora there. And the government Malaysia make Proton as the official supplier for the government vehicles. For trade, Proton remains the top vehicle sales in 2019 in Malaysia, and there is a rising competition in the developing market such as Honda and Toyota, and also the increase of full price. So for the next is SO strategy option. So Proton should boost the process of internalization, improve the technical R&D in Tanjung Malim plant. For WO, they should improve the brand image and also specification of customer, and also improve the positive view of local and overseas market. For the ST, they should increase the expansion to global market in order to minimize the loss of market share, and set up the joint venture strategic alliance in order to improve the operation and also network of the Proton. And for the WT, they should produce more new car model with the unique design, high specification and also performance engine, and also maintain the market position of the market. So that's all for my part. I will pass to next member. Thank you.
Okay, now I'm going to continue the space matrix of Proton. There are four quadrant framework indicate four main strategies, which is aggressive, conservative, defensive, and competitive. The evaluations of the Proton will be based on the financial positions, competitive positions, stability positions, and also the industry positions. Based on the average score shown by the evaluations of Proton, Proton should be more aggressive in running their business as it has a strong competitive positions in the market. With rapid growth, it needs to use its internal strength to develop a market penetrations and market development strategies. Proton should also pursue their strategies such as the backward integrations, forward integrations, horizontal integrations, product development, and diversifications in order to strengthen their business performance. That's all from me. Thank you.
based on proton's strategic position and using the calculation and quantitative strategic planning methods, we can conclude that the best strategy to be implemented is strategy 2, which is an improvement in the existing car model to be more fuel efficiency. The sum total attractiveness score of strategy 1 is 3.47, while for strategy 2 is 3.87. Strategy 2 score higher compared to strategy 1. High score of quantitative strategic planning metrics indicates the attractiveness of level of the strategy. The higher the score, the more attractive the strategy would be. With considering all the relevant external and internal factors could affect the strategic decisions. Product development, as Proton should make improvement on the existing car model to be more fuel efficiency, can be conducted to improve Proton's business performance.
Salam sejahtera, Doctor. My name is Siap Sin Mei. In this group assignment, I will present about the decision sets of Proton. Vertical integration is a strategy used by a company to gain control over its supplier or distribution in order to increase the firm power in the marketplace and reduce the cost. By implementing the vertical integration strategy, Proton can control its supplier or distributor channel to control its value or supply chains. There are three integration strategies can use by Proton, which is forward integration, backward integration, and horizontal integration. For forward integration, Proton can implement forward integration, which is set up more sales and service outlets to generalize their new car model. Backward integration enables Proton to manufacture and produce their own original part for the assembling and replacing purpose. By doing so, Proton can keep a check on quality and economizing its cost of auto part, which is ultimately help the company and its customer by providing a quality product at a better price. In the horizontal integration strategy, Proton can consider to acquisition other automotive engineering company and manufacturer to develop their existing car model to be more fuel efficiency. Vertical integration is important for Proton to improve their profitability and achieve their goal.
Salam sejahtera, Dr. Stas. I'm Zhang Hongfeng. My metric number is FP1702XS. First, I would like to discuss about intensive strategies. Proton must decide whether to strengthen their organizations by pursuing an intensive strategies includes market penetration, market development, and product development. In market penetration strategy, Proton can reduce price, increase promotion and distribution support, and upgrade its existing car models. With the implementation of market penetration strategy, it allows Proton to rebuild their brand image and thus increase the profitability. Next, market development. Proton can expand into new markets using its existing products by targeting different customer segments. Proton needs to explore new market segments in the automotive industry to increase the profitability. Next, product development. Proton can invest in the development on an aluminium body vehicle and increase fuel efficiency. With the purpose to fit the budget of the general population, Proton can put effort in the development of new low-cost flexible engine, which will bring its car price even lower. Now, I would like to discuss about diversification strategies. Proton has characteristically high cash flow levels and limited internal growth needs and often can pursue related or unrelated diversification successfully. In related diversification strategy, Proton can expand its business by producing Goodyear tires so the company can have its full control over its tire suppliers. Furthermore, an acquisition of Goodyear tires can provide tires which can meet the needs of raw materials in the manufacturing process. Next, unrelated diversification strategy. Firms that employ unrelated diversification continually search across different industries that have a high potential return on investment. Now, I would like to discuss about defensive strategy. There are three types of defensive strategies, which are refreshment, divestiture, and liquidation, should be considered by Proton in achieving the organization goals effectively and efficiency. In a retrenchment strategy, the company may cut cost of the operation to avoid from getting losses.
Retrenchment strategy is aimed at making proton more productive and profitable to improve the weakness. Thus, proton can take any potential opportunities available in the market to continue to gain the profit in the automotive industry. Next, divestiture strategy. Through divestiture strategy, proton can raise its capital for further strategy acquisitions or investment in research and development. Next, liquidation strategy. This strategy is adopted when the organization plans to close its business operation or bankrupt. However, a shareholders may prefer to sell all the company's assets than pay the large amount of liabilities incurred by the organization. Thank you.
Besides that, Proton also use a Michael Porter 5 generic strategy to do decision. Michael Porter 5 generic strategy is a category of strategy consisting of three general types of strategy that are mostly used by business to achieve their and maintain their competitive advantage. Michael Porter 5 generic including the three types of strategy, which is cost leadership, differentiation, and focus strategy. Cost leadership describes when a firm provides the same or similar service or product as a firm but does so at a lower price. For example, the price of new car must be lower than the competitor so that Proton can compete with other firms and get a higher profit. In addition, differentiation means a firm offers a superior product at a similar cost to other firms' inferior product. Apart from achieving the fuel efficiency, Proton must be unique appearance design in their new car model to attract the customer. The last one is focus. Focus means a company or firm will focus on a narrow segment of the market. There will become a specialization in this area and appeal to a niche customer base. So Proton must identify the customer target market of the new model car to reach the right audience. That's all for my part. Thank you.
As a conclusion, we can come to conclusion that the greatest master plan to be carried out is Strategy 2, which is an advance in the existing car to be more fuel efficiency. Secondly, the sum total attractiveness scores STAS of Strategy 1 is 3.47 model, while the Strategy 2 is 3.87. Strategy 2 scored higher compared to Strategy 1. High score of QSPM indicates the quality level of the strategy. The higher the scores, the more attractive the strategy will be with considering all the relevant external and internal factors could affect the strategy decisions. Product development as Protons should make improvement on the existing car model to be more fuel efficiency can be conducted to improve Proton's business performance. Last but not least, Proton have possibilities in order to conduct well in the international market. With the power that they have, they can perform in the international industry if they use all the resistance that they have. That's all from us. Thank you.